some correction at this point.
Sure. Why don't we all send our comments and let Sarah redo the minutes, and then we can vote on it, leave it up to her to redo.
That would be helpful. So I think my style of coming from what I've done minutes is very different than what you're looking for, which I apologize. And I'm happy to take and redo them. So if you can get them to me, but I'm on 3 sets of minutes now, so if I could have them by Wednesday, I would really appreciate it, because we're in the middle of getting absentee ballots out, and then I have 3 sets of minutes to do. So that would be preferred. And I'm happy to incorporate everything, and then we send out the first two for sure. This next one will come along after. Does that help? Okay.
So if some of you have noticed, I've been taking some minutes with Sarah tonight, because the amount of time that the clerk is spending on minutes alone is becoming
an issue. And you have some suggestions to me.
Right, in the balance of priorities. So you're going to see me doing this for a little while, but I'm also asking for your patience as we go along. Not everyone is going to have what they want out of the minutes, but the minutes aren't designed to be that way. We do want to be attentive and meet some spectrum of medium. But once, I go through this with Sarah and kind of doing it once or twice, we're going to recommend how we proceed with it, and then I'm going to be asking for you guys to proceed with us. Because we need to move on to other things.
And can I just ask, Rebecca mentioned earlier in the meeting, and I apologize, President Johnson, that it may help them in their minute taking to not make a motion before we have discussion. So I don't know if that's something we want to consider, but she did mention at the beginning of the meeting, so.
Well, it gets very confusing for you guys when you keep making multiple amendments to a motion. It just is. It's confusing. I couldn't even track it when you guys started at the beginning, because I was more worried about content and trying to, and how I was helping Sarah.
And I was more worried about the motion, because there were so many, that I'm missing your content. So,
we need to let you know that this is a lot. This is not, we want to work with you, but this is, we need to come to some form of medium. And it's two of people coming to you saying, we want to help make it work with you, but we're going to need to come to a different, we need a new normal.
And if you have any recommendations other than that for us, please,
sure.
Please share with us.
Yeah. So we're going to keep word what you can expect from us, and then I'm going to keep talking to you about it.
We cut back the amount of, I was surprised how much more content was in these last, on the discussion. We had kind of trimmed back a little bit on multiple comments and stuff.
Well, and as you know, you guys have a ton of new staff, so, and we're just genuinely trying to figure out, because we all come from a little bit of a different style.
I would just say, this board has had, some considerable discussion about minutes and sparse minutes and more detailed minutes. I think when Diane was doing them, I think that was a happy medium. We were all kind of happy with them. So that might be a good reference for you.
Yeah, so I actually did went back and asked Diane about that and how that process worked for me, because I agree, that actually got brought up.
That at the Larry Arfpack tournament, too.
Oh, okay. I don't know what the archive was, but I'm just going to say today. But, I was like, Dan, how much time are you spending on these minutes? And she went back on one topic, and she was like, oh, I'm just in this one discussion. I spent, how long was it?
It was an hour. So I gave her a piece of January's minutes, and I said, can you do this piece? And let me know, can I compare my notes to hers? And it was 1 hour. So at a 4-hour meeting tonight, it will take me a full day of minutes. I do take these home. Like, I don't do them at work. I do them at home. Because I can't possibly close my door for 8 hours and not have any interruptions and re-listen and rehash all this stuff again. I love it, and this is what I signed up for, but I got to find a meeting.
Well, it's actually the last tape. She listened to it 3 times. So when you look at the second of your meeting,
and we do have to find a happy medium, and I would say that possibly that the ones that Diane was doing is not the happy medium that we're going to
do. I was going to say, I'm not saying that, but I was.
So We're going to keep communicating on it, but I'm just letting you know, because I know that that's probably not your intention either. Like, I know that you want us to also be efficient, so we're going to, your meetings go much longer than a lot of other meetings, you know, so for us, that's also, you know, and we're not judging that, but it also does correlate directly until the cleanup. So, well, you know, we're going to keep working on it.
And just so you know, the draft sometimes may be very drafty, just so that you can see because of time constraints. So I'm going to try to at least produce something.
So key things.
Yes.
We want to work with you, we're going to keep working on it, and we're going to try to establish a new normal moving forward.
Thank you.
And communicate to you along the way.
Okay, let's move on.
Can I just make a comment? I just want to say thank you very much, and I appreciate really understanding how things that we ask for impact your day and what's going on in the organization, because otherwise it's hard to know. So thank you very much.
Okay. Did you have
some? No, I'm ready to move.
Okay. So we're going to skip item 8 now and just skip through with the report so we can get into item 8 separately. So the reports from village officials, I have none. Any other reports from trustees?
Just one. At the finance committee meeting, I had requested that at some point in the future that Mark bring to the committee and then to the full board some report on the possible range of options for the village to undertaking in response to the change in federal tax laws as it relates to the deductibility of property tax, and if there's any other way we can, he knows what we're doing, but the point is we're looking at that. He's looking at that, and we'll talk about that.
Thank you. Any other reports from trustees?
No.
Reports from village manager? And items for future consideration. Yes.
I had just asked Mark, and I just rather than send an email, if we could get a breakdown at some point from the police department would have it, but just of enforcement, like how many in a year, how many tickets do we give out for blowing stop signs? Or he said they bring up, there is a breakdown real easy in Duncan. So if we could just run that report, because we are getting a lot of requests from citizens just looking for a summary information that.
So breakdown would be important there.
Just what is, yeah. Like there's probably not a lot of speeding, you know, that takes radar guns, but I'm sure they're handing out tickets for like, you know, not stopping at a stop sign or taking a right where you're supposed to not take a right, you know, a red light. So those kind of things are coming up a lot. So just.
Any other reports?
We did discuss on the collection, changing our collection programs, that the new cards would go out the end of March, which is now 2 months from where we are now. And I would hate to have another very quick and rushed public information process. So I'm hoping that we can get a communication plan or some update from the DPW on how they're planning to inform the public. And it should be starting soon. We're 2 months away.
And we asked I have asked that our staff review that. We have not done the task timelines as specifically as we did for like drive at the time that this had happened on November 20th. So I've asked them to update that in a similar format and put the dates to it and things and then resend that so that everyone help it. A reminder is always needed.
Are you going to bring that as a communication plan for us to adopt or no?
Well, she had it broken down in the same type of format. I believe the specific dates were in there, but the time frames, like months, like it would say something like beginning of March or, you know, like, but it didn't have like the specific dates of the tasks were going to happen. So I was just gonna have her use what she had presented to you and that we have reviewed that night on November 20th and update that with a specific date so that you guys would know when it was leaving our office.
And lastly, I'm sorry, I missed budget, but if we could just get Mark City to bring back to this budget that just happened committee, which I wasn't at, but a listing of those contracts and his proposed his proposed timeline for RP.
Yep, as the last budget and finance committee meeting, there was agreement that that was going to be done after the close of the first quarter, with the first quarter report.
Hmm. Okay.
Okay.
So I hate to burden staff with something else, but I think this is possibly very beneficial to our community for a variety of reasons. The league forwarded us some information on applying for the healthy community designation. So it would, there are three different levels, just like the bike friendliness, you know, bronze, silver, and gold. The application process, I've looked it over, it's different depending, you have to announce which designation you're applying for. But it's relatively short, I guess, I mean, relative to what. But so I don't know if there's a committee, a village committee that maybe look this over, and I'll send the link on it. I'm kind of too tired right now to be articulate as far as this is concerned. But I think that we are doing a lot of the initiatives that in Sherwood currently and have considered some of them in our Vision 2025, that this healthy community designation award, or whatever you want to call it, calls for.
Designation.
Thank you, designation. Yeah. So anyway, that's, I'll send more information to the full board. And
okay, any other reports? I mean, any other items for future consideration? Okay. So with that, I'd like to move to item 11, but we're not, because we'll go back to item 8. Is there a motion to go into closed session?
I move to adjourn the closed session pursuant to Wisconsin Statute 1985E, deliberating and negotiating the purchase of public properties, investment, public funding, conducting other specified public business, member competitive bargaining reasons require a closed session to discuss the possible sale of the village's fire station.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call vote.
Yes.
Yes. Hi,
Tyler.
I haven't been trained on that.
I have.